We are being cheated. Some of our tax money strangely disappears into the dark. But how much, where and how? How much money is laundered each year? How much tax money is evaded each year? It is impossible to measure things like money laundering and tax evasion, simply because they are by definition hidden in the dark by criminals. But what if we still want to analyze these phenomena? What if we want to know how big these problems are in order to test whether policies tackle the problem? We may not be able to measure these problems, but we can make an estimation. Analyzing money laundering and tax evasion is like looking at a dark map, where every now and then we get some light, a bit of information, because a criminal is caught or because a whistleblower reveals information about what is happening in the dark. For instance, when the documents of a law firm in Panama showed us how the wealthy are trying to hide behind offshore companies, the Panama Papers. Scholars constantly disagree on what the real amount could be. For instance, we, economists from Utrecht University, estimate the amount of money laundering in the tens of billions of euro per year in the Netherlands, with our most recent estimate being 16 billion euros, while other scholars claim that the amount is only millions. This difference mostly comes from the information one uses to estimate the amount. If you look at discovered cases, and for instance how many criminal assets were confiscated by the Dutch police, one would see only millions, with the most recent estimate being 171 million, only about 1% of 16 billion. We approach the estimation very differently. We use a so-called gravity model to estimate the amount of money laundering across the world. The gravity model comes from the original gravity equation in physics, discovered by Isaac Newton. With this formula, we know exactly what happens if I stop holding this apple. We can calculate the gravity force with the mass of the Earth, the mass of the apple, and the distance between the two. Jan Tinbergen, a Nobel Prize-winning economist, introduced this formula into economics by applying it to trade. He showed that you can predict trade with a gravity formula. Countries trade more when they are bigger and closer to each other. Economists have been applying this gravity model successfully ever since to many international relations, like tourism, migration, and many others. So, it was only a matter of time before it also got applied to criminal international contexts, like money laundering, drugs trade, and suspicious bank transfers. Our gravity model for money laundering starts with an estimation on how much money is made from crime across the world and how much of that money needs to be laundered. We then use the gravity equation with assumptions on what criminals are looking for, like bank secrecy, to estimate where all this money will be laundered. This gives us a chance to estimate the size of the iceberg instead of keep staring at only the tip of the iceberg, which would happen when focusing only on the known cases. We need to focus on the known cases to understand how criminals behave, but we also need estimation models to get an idea of how big the problem is and how much we are missing. We should not argue about whether these estimations are correct, but how we can improve them. We must accept that estimation models will always be discussable. At the same time, they are necessary if we want to know how big the problem of money laundering and tax evasion really is. My name is Joras Ferwerda, and I work for the EU project Coffers, which is about combating fiscal fraud and empowering regulators. No one should be left in the dark. Neither should our money.